Okay, and we're live at the Steven Udvar Hazy site, the center of the Air and Space Museum here in Virginia. And in front of me is Space Shuttle Discovery. So you're looking at Space Shuttle Discovery here at the Steven Udvar Hazy Center in Virginia. These are just concept models, what the shuttle may have looked like. Okay, and just below the shuttle is the Canada arm. I mean, the great thing about this museum is that you can get incredibly close to the shuttle, almost within touching distance.
This one, in this case, is not at all bad. It means it was surprising.
One more.
This is the museum in Virginia. Okay, we'll look at some of the other exhibits here. This is a Mercury capsule, Freedom 7-2. It was never used. Okay, we're going to go for a bit of a walk here. What we're going to see is hopefully Columbia, which is the command module for Apollo 11. It's not actually out in display. It's actually in another part of the museum. It's being refurbished at the moment. But we should be able to still see it. Okay, above us is just a number of different satellites and space probes.
Flies like a brick.
Okay, through here is the like the restoration hangar. And if we walk around to the far side, we should see the Apollo 11 command module, hopefully. Okay. Yep, it's, you probably can't see it, but it's still there. What's happening, this is being refurbished a bit. It is going to go on a tour to commemorate the 50 years since the landing of Apollo 11. I think it's going to go to 4 different cities. Yeah.
Excuse me, sir.
No, it's not. It's a stabilizer. Just for the video. It's not. It doesn't do anything. Just keeps the video straight.
Okay. No, I've seen it.
Yeah.
I was walking in and I had a cousin of mine in and I was bringing him over showing the museum. And at the far end of this hallway, there's a large conference room, this glass wall conference room. And
okay, that is Columbia. That's the actual command module that the Apollo 11 astronauts came back in.
And they were all working diligently on something. And I walked and I showed my cousin all these guys in the restoration shop. And, or, you know, in the conference room, and we walk up, and there was one fellow in there, Scott Woods, in the shop. He said, well, you see all those people in there? They're planning on telling that guy what squib term next.
It joins the National Collection of 1916. Now, I can't remember what 4 cities the Columbia is actually going to, but you'll find that out online if you can actually see it and get close to it. It'll soon be well worth taking. Okay, I'm just going to go through to another part of the museum here. Okay, this is coming into the aircraft section. A lot of famous aircraft actually in here. You have the Another Gay, the aircraft that dropped the first atomic bomb, which I think we're just coming up on now. It has Concorde, it has a Blackbird. Okay, just ahead is the Enola Gay.
That's the one where these guys were afloat on the coast of the island. It's pretty.
Thank you.
aircraft restoration tour is now beginning at the tour desk on the lower level of the rear of the Starfleet.
Another few here of the Enola Gay. That was a P-51 Mustang. Okay, the obligatory gift shop.
You're already in line buying stuff.
Okay, we're just going to come up here onto the Blackbird.
Thank you. like this.
Blackbird.
Please, now.
out if you need to rescue them from their rocket?
Yes. You don't do so. It's just...
Up there is the actual space suit and rocket pack used by Bruce McClandless when he's on his EVA. This is the engineering model of the figure sort of probe. This actually went to Venus. One of the landers actually landed on the surface, but actually managed to survive. I think it was only for a matter of minutes, but they did send back two or three photographs. But it was a miracle given how hostile the surface of Venus is. It was a real achievement. One to land and two to send back any images. Sojourner and Pathfinder. One of the first Mars rovers. Thank you. Okay, and that's another quick tour. This time with the Steven Hazy Center, Udvar Hazy Center. I mean, if for nothing else, you want to get here just to see Discovery. And you're standing literally just a couple of feet away from it. So it's Atlantis I've seen, Discovery I've seen. Next month, hopefully, I'll be in California and I'll see Endeavour.